The Cuban Missile Crisis. Junior Certificate History by ExamLearn.
In the year of 1959, Fidel Castro and Ernesto Guevara overthrew a corrupt dictatorship in Cuba and established a communist country. The Americans were not happy with communists being so close to their border, and so they placed an embargo on Cuba. This stopped all trade between the two countries. Cuba went to the USSR for help as they had lost their largest exporter, and Nikita Khrushchev agreed to buy their main export, which was sugar. This angered the USA, and in 1601 they invaded Cuba, but it was a failure, and they were defeated at the Bay of Pigs due to bad organization. This made Cuba look for even more assistance, and Khrushchev sent them military equipment and advisors. John F. Kennedy, who was the president of the USA at the time, worried that the USSR were locating missiles in Cuba. He sent U-2 spy planes over Cuba and discovered that the USSR had set up intermediate-range ballistic missiles which could hit USA in 3 minutes. JFK was unsure what to do, and so he met with his advisors. On the 22nd of October 1962, JFK asked on live television for Khrushchev to remove the missiles, or he would place a Navy blockade around Cuba. He announced a full-scale attack on Russia if missiles were fired, or if they tried to break through the blockade. He placed B-52 bombers armed with nuclear bombs above Cuba. Khrushchev sent military ships towards Cuba, and the world waited for another world war. Thankfully, he finally ordered the ships to stop on the 24th of October, and on the 28th of the same month a compromise was made. USSR agreed to remove the missiles if the USA promised not to attack Cuba. The USA also secretly removed missiles from Turkey on the USSR border to prevent further conflict. There were three results of these events. Although there was very nearly a full-scale war, this led to improved cooperation in the future. USA and USSR created a hotline in the offices of both presidents to improve communications. And the Cuban Missile Crisis led to the introduction of the 1963 Test Ban Treaty, which banned the testing of nuclear weapons on land or at sea.